Vegas sun is a little different than California sun. Amen. This get hot. Amen. No humidity instead. Amen. God is good. Amen. I have been having me, amen, a good time.
Amen.
Today, amen. Radio early. I went on and listened. Amen. Hallelujah. And I got tangled up. Amen, man. Amen. Bishop Holcomb just kept saying, Dr. Daniels, you want to answer that? You want to answer that? You want to answer that? Amen. So, but we had a good time. It was really, really good. Amen. And, you know, we have Bible study now, but listening in on the radio, amen, we go a little bit in more in depth than, you know, sometimes when you come here, amen, the Lord knows you're here. And when he knows that you're here, he starts speaking to you. Or you can be where you're not conscious, but in your own subconscious or in your spirit, you're crying out for something. You're crying out for an answer. God will take that, no matter who it is. It could be on television. God can take that vessel, amen, and start to bring that word forth right to you for that time, right for that moment. It'll just come right forward, amen, and it'll be yours. So when you come and sit, God knows you're here, amen, and he just starts ministering to you, amen.
Amen.
Glory to God.
Amen.
A rhema word, amen, hallelujah, and praise God. You know, when you, the first 3 days, I personally didn't ask who's on the phone, I mean, because I just want to minister, amen, by the Spirit of God, amen, hallelujah. Some people, that's as everybody who come in, just come out, say your name, and all of that stuff, amen. I could minister not knowing you there, somebody jump on and say, oh, wow. You really ministered to my heart today. I really, whoa. Amen. Hallelujah. Every now and then you hear somebody shout on the radio, whoa. Amen. Because the word is coming. The word has got them. Amen. Where? Amen. They are. So I thank God for that. Amen. Tune in. Tell somebody about it. Amen. Glory to God. I see some things coming together. Amen, because there was time left over. Some more ministers in town got some time, amen, that they can do their teaching, do their talking, do whatever it is that they're doing. They got some time, amen. And so what I see coming together, amen, is some fellowship,
amen,
amen, where, amen, we can do conferences. Like an evangelistic conference, prophetic conference, apostolic conference, a gathering of the saints, amen. And the word can be ministered, amen. People can be charged and encouraged. So I'm excited about what the Lord is doing, amen. Hallelujah. You know, sometimes, amen, we have to make sure that we see what the Lord is doing. Because the Lord spoke to me, he said, it will be slower than what you first anticipated, but it'll be greater than you ever imagined.
Amen. Amen.
Take your time. Amen. Don't be in a rush. Don't put forth no gimmicks. Amen. You don't need them. Amen. People come to you for gimmicks. Guess what? You got to keep on giving them a gimmick every single time. You got to keep on giving them Kool-Aid. Amen?
Amen.
Praise God. So we're not trying to do that. We're trying to build something solid here. Amen? Glory to God. And the main thing to do is stay faithful and keep the course. Just stay faithful, keep the course. Stay faithful, keep the course. You know, can you imagine, anybody can imagine what a church would be like with no prayer in it? It'd be a pretty bad shape, wouldn't it? No prayer. advanced faith. When he said the house of God would be a house of prayer, and then they had no prayer, oh my. But think about a church that's solid in prayer. I'm talking about solid in prayer like we were tonight. Amen. Hallelujah. 6 o'clock, there's people here praying. Amen. Here praying. 6 o'clock. Amen. You see, when there's a stampede to the prayer closet, then that's when you'll see a move of God. Amen. And then when other people come in, we don't have to teach them how to, amen, how to break crab legs. You know, you take the thing and you do it like this, you know, and do crab leg. We're going to have a crab leg fellowship. Or, amen, now nothing wrong with eating crab, having crab fest and all of that. But we can take saints and we can teach them how to pray.
Amen.
Amen. We can see, let them see the example of prayer. Because most of the time when people walk in and they see what everybody's doing and they decide to join in, they will do what everybody else is doing. They'll get a hold to it. Amen. And then what you have is people coming here for the right reason. Coming here because, man, the prayer is strong. Can you imagine what that is? What that'll be like? Man, I'm going over there because they pray strong.
Amen.
Huh? Now that's a good reason for people to turn up here, right?
Amen.
Amen. Or they come and say, man, that word, amen, is dissected. It's in there. Amen. You could talk to any one of them and they just take you right to the word and start elaborating on it. That's what I want to do. I want to be able to do that word like that. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Now you come because what? The prayer is exciting and the word is exciting. Amen.
Amen.
Where the choir comes, the choir comes. We have a choir. Amen. Glory to God. We'll do all of those things. We have a little choir. Amen. Praise team, worshipers, dancers, all of that. But that can't be too aggressive. If people come in to see your dancers, then what? They go to Smith Center and do that. Amen. Glory to God. The apostle said, you just get some people and put over this business so we can go ahead and give ourselves to prayer and the word of God. Remember
Amen.
That?
Amen.
Y'all remember. Amen. So let's turn our Bibles over to Amen. Glory to God. Y'all got a 1 Timothy?
Yeah.
That's where we are, right?
Yeah.
I think we finished up what we did. Let's start at 12. And I thank Christ Jesus our Lord who hath enabled me. Now, that could be said like this, and it wouldn't do an injustice to it. I thank the Lord Jesus Christ who graced me. Because here, grace is an enabling power. Now, grace don't mean, amen, son, I don't know why some people, when they hear grace, the first thing they think of is that's giving you a license to sin. It is not. That's not what grace does at all. Now, if a person does sin, grace covers him. Amen. They can get back, amen, and confess the sin, be forgiven. He's faithful and just to forgive us, cleanse us from all unrighteousness. He just wipes it right away. Amen. And then we push on. We go forward. But there's no reason why we just walk up and just start to screaming, I'm going to sin because I got grace. Well, I would say to that person, get bone again. Huh? Bone again. Amen. I go in one of them preachers like that. You must be bone again. Amen. Hallelujah. Because that nature of God hasn't grasped. Amen. Hallelujah. Because as you go forward, in the grace of God, It seems like the deeper you go into the grace of God, the more of a, I don't want to say conviction. I'll say you're not comfortable in anything that's not of God. Amen. Because it say he'll convict the world. You know, saints running around talking about they're under conviction. I mean, maybe it's that. I don't know. I haven't seen it. I heard when Jesus said about conviction, he said, I mean, he's going to convict the world of sin because they don't believe because they can't see it. Amen. They never believe. But a believer, when we're going forward, amen, I would say you're uneasy. Because it says, let the peace of God do what? Rule, reign. Amen. Let the peace of God rule. Which means let the peace of God be an umpire. The peace of God will tell us what should be out, what should say. Okay? Hallelujah. Glory to God. This baseball season, y'all. Glory to God. Amen. But the peace of God, that's what it means. He's an umpire. The peace of God is the umpire, according to Colossians 3 and 15. Amen. So Paul say, he who enabled me, for that he counted me faithful, putting me into the ministry. That's really enabling, isn't it? Amen. For him to be as bad as he was, that would take some enabling by the Lord. And the Lord say, okay, I make you fit. I enable you to do it. Matter of fact, I count you faithful, Paul, and I'm putting you into the ministry. Well, what was he faithful in? He was faithful in doing the wrong thing. Amen. Glory to God. You see, in the church, you have wrong people doing the wrong thing, right people doing the wrong thing, wrong people doing the right thing. Amen. But what God wants is the right people doing the right thing. Amen. Sometimes when you're new, like we are, you just have to get people to do. Amen. What you can get them to do. You got to get it done, right? Amen. Glory to God. But he said, God counted me faithful, putting me in the ministry because he enabled me. Who was before a blasphemer and a persecutor and injurious, but I obtained mercy because I did it what?
Ignorantly
and unbelief. Amen. Hallelujah. Just ignoring it and not believing. Amen. He was fighting against it. And now we're in the 14th verse. And the grace of our Lord was exceeding abundant with faith and love, which is in Christ Jesus. Amen. The grace of our Lord, which is exceeding, amen, and abundant. Doesn't that sound like someplace else? What scripture is that?
3:20.
Amen. Glory to God. Now to him who is able to do exceedingly and abundantly above all we could ask or think according to the power that works in us. And he's telling us now that power, some of that power that's working in us is grace, exceeding abundant grace, and with faith and love, which is in Christ Jesus. Now those are some good things to have working in you. Amen. And good things that we acknowledge that is working on the inside of us. Amen. Abundant with faith and love, which is in Christ Jesus. Grace. Amen. Abundant grace, faith, and love is in Christ Jesus. And where are we?
In Christ Jesus.
All right, so we write in there where grace abundant, exceeding. Amen. Abundant. Where faith is, where love is, we are right in the same place. So the place where we live is a place of grace. It's a place of faith, a place of love. Amen. We're in Christ Jesus. Now watch this. This is a faithful saying and worthy of all acceptation. That Christ Jesus came into the world to do what?
To save sinners.
Of whom I am chief. So the reason why Paul is saying, I could get people saved, is because I know why Jesus came. He came to save sinners, and he said, I'm chief, so I could tell you how to do it. Amen. Like my nephew said, Uncle, you're going to make a real good preacher. I said, why you say that? He said, you know all about sin. Glory to God. Huh? Now people act like they ain't never sinned before. Can you just imagine you see saints of God like they never were sinners? Huh? Oh, no. I'm going to tell you something. I don't have no time to be judging nobody but trying to get people to Christ. Because I know as much and enriched in his grace, amen, that he was for me, he can be the same way for the next person. Hallelujah. I could talk about sin because it's gone. I'm not doing that today. But I know what it looks like. Are you hearing me? I know how it works. People thinking you don't know how it works. In sin up to the eyebrow. And that's think don't nobody. Man, come on with that. Amen. Because you know what? The fruits of it don't show. That's almost like the guy, right? It's a church function, right? But he wanna drink. So guess what he did? He sneak outside. Well, I told him, if you keep sneaking outside, everybody in here gonna know you've been going out there to their cars. And now you better hold this. That's enough. Just have you two, and that'll be it. Because I know. Oh, I know what whiskey'll do. Whiskey'll sit right here on top of this thing, and you can tell whiskey jump. Run. Hop. Whiskey ain't gonna even move. But it get in you and tell you to do all kind of crazy stuff. Amen. Glory to God. Like the man say, he drunk on the railroad track. He said, it's the longest flight of stairs I ever seen in my life. And who put the handrail so far? He's on some track, thought he on the thing. Amen. But what is out there in the car, that whiskey? It's going to come back in. So every time he go out there to that whiskey and get that whiskey in the car, he get a little bit louder. Just a little bit louder. Finally, I say, I think we better go. You grab him, walk him on out. I said, man, I think we better get out. We better go. But that whiskey finna tell on you in the church. Amen. So what's done out there, it manifests. It's just wide open. Nobody, man, listen, the gestures, the movement, all of that, it just tell on you. Don't be deceived. God's not mocked. Whatever man sows, that shall he also reap. There ain't but one thing to do, and that's get saved. And once we get saved, all of that, I don't care how many people Saint Paul persecuted, how many he threw out of the houses, how many, amen, he watched while they stoned to death, he watched the coat. I don't care what he did. When he came to Christ, that's why I like listening to this man's reading. Why? Because he's a chief sinner. Who could tell you more about the abundance of God's grace and the abundance of God's salvation than somebody that's been in sin? Well, ain't never. What? Who you think you're talking to? You ain't never did. You might not have done that, but you did this him. Are you hearing me? Some of the stuff you just be ashamed to talk about you did in the world. You can't testify to it. It wouldn't do nobody no good if you testified to it. No. Scratch. It's under the blood. It's gone. Are you hearing me? So all of us were sinners? No, let me not say include y'all, because some people walk around like they never was sinners and probably still is. Amen. Hallelujah. Just still is. Because you recognize the more, amen, you contact the Holy Spirit of God. You know, like I tell people, I'm from I'm from Chicago, it snows. It's nothing like fresh snow. Oh, man. You know, after being out here in the desert, you go in that fresh snow, my mama said, what are you doing outside? Oh, I want you to drink some of this snow. But if you take this book right here that looks white, it looks white. But if you put it up against that fresh snow, it's not. And anytime any of us put ourselves up against Jesus, we got a ways to go. We got a ways to go. Amen. Glory to God. A ways to go. You just keep on learning different things about Jesus all the time. This salvation, let me tell you something. We was walking this way. Every person born was walking away from God. Walking the other way. Then repentance is not a 360. 180. Because you're going that way, now you start going this way. Now, don't tell me you saved and you still going that way. You can't tell the difference between you and one of the people on TV. Amen. That's not a condemnation. That's saying, hey, let's come up to, amen, let's come up to par. Amen. If it's not salvation, ask God. God help me. Let the new creation, let the nature, your divine nature take, amen, hold of me and use me, amen, and bring me forward into what I'm supposed to be. Don't leave me like this. Amen. I know when I was backslidden, I probably listened to T.D. Jakes preach 2,500 times. His message was, Lord, it's not my will to be like this. Oh, my God. I had it in the car. I played over and over. I can hear Jakes right now saying, Lord, it's not my will to be like this. Oh, my God. Nobody could tell you. The nights I was in my car driving down the road crying because I knew that backslidden state and living like that. Let me tell you something. You can live in the hog pen all you want to and eat pus, it'll get you full. Until you come to yourself and find out you in a hog pen. Amen. Some people all the way over in the hog pen. And become such a good actor that they think people don't know they're in the hog pen. Those actions, those motions, amen, you can tell, amen, who been out to the car drinking the whiskey. Huh? You can tell. I mean, that's just a parable. But he was a sinner. I was a sinner. I didn't know any other way. Amen. The only person I think I was exposed to was my grandmother, who was a Christian, then the Jacksons, who was a older Caucasian couple who came from First Baptist Church, amen, and they come and teach Bible study, amen, but we were going there because Miss Jackson could bake real good and we'd always get some cupcakes or something, amen, some candy, so we'd go there and sit at that little Bible study on Monday. Amen, we were such sinners, we lied on them people and told them, amen, that the man hit us. Amen. And people was up there ready to persecute the man. That's how bad sinners we were. Amen. The people bring candy to school to have a fundraiser. You know how they bring all them bars of candy to school? They have them stacked up in the boxes. We done stole all their candy. Told the man, don't take it home. Don't take that candy home. Well, he took it home. Granddaddy found it. Then he snitched. Wasn't a good day. Amen. It just wasn't a good day. But my grandmother would always plant the seed She would always plant the seed. She would always plant the seed. And then I didn't want, you know, in the Baptist church, they have what they call shouting. You know, they get in there, woo, they get to shouting, and they just go wild. I mean, it's almost like, and every time I go to church with my mama, her and her cousin, my cousin, my mama and cousin Pearl would get happy. All they'd say, and always sit together. Amen. Glory to God. I thank God for her. Amen. For cousin Pearl and for my mother. Amen. But know nothing about no church, stuff like that. Sinners. Sinners. Just man, we were still the light out of day. Lie. See who could cuss the most. We 8 years old walking around cussing. Huh? You know, Stevie Wonder say smoking cigarettes, hanging out with them hooligan friends of mine. That's how I knew was sin. Sin, 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 sin. But one day, amen, I gave my life to God. I gave my life. I accepted the Lord Jesus as my Lord. I accepted him as my Savior. Amen. Hallelujah. Glory to God. I accepted him as my Lord and as my Savior. Amen. I give him glory for that. Did you do the same thing? Did you accept the Lord? Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah. That you have the dose of the dose. Amen. Glory to God. Hallelujah. He came to save sinners whom I'm chief. Now how be it, for this cause I obtained mercy. Why? Being a great sinner. That in me, first Jesus Christ might show forth all long suffering for a pattern to them which should hereafter believe on him to life everlasting. So it looks at it, and the reason why, amen, some of us, amen, were brought from where we were so people could look at us and say, if God could save him, or if God could save her, he could save anybody.
Amen.
This person can get turned on and be on fire for God. Amen. We were joking, teasing around last night on the radio program, amen, with Pastor Bobby Florence, amen, and he was like, well, this guy right here, he said, man, I get away from him because I wasn't living the way I was supposed to live. And he used to say, I don't know how in the world God saved him. And so I said to him, how you sitting there judging me? You the reason they put the streetlights in the alley. Amen. I said, hey, we come a long way running up and down the alley with them suitcases full of $100 bills. We come a long ways from that. Now both of us own, amen, a radio teaching the word of God. And let me tell you something, he's gunpowder. I'm telling you, he's the real deal. If you ever free between 9 o'clock, 7 o'clock and 9 o'clock our time, tune in. 641-715. Hallelujah. 3580 with an access code of 610. Amen. 739-POUND. That's 641 area code. 715-3580. With an access code of 610-739. This man is bringing. Amen. He's bringing. Bishop Holcomb is on there. Amen. Between 11 o'clock and 1 o'clock on Wednesdays and Fridays. You got other stuff that's coming forth. This is 24 hours, 7 days a week. It's a seed venture. It's going to grow into something even mightier amen, than we could ever imagine. Amen. It's good when you hear that, that means people are coming on. I have to just stop right there and they want me to keep going. Just keep, come on, guys. Now I got to go to prayer. I got to pray. Amen. Glory to God. Then I get on there this morning, they go, 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 go. So I be going. I be doing what I love to do. I love doing this. I was a sinner. I was a sinner. I'm a church boy. I might not have always done things the way that they were supposed to be, but I've been in the church 35 years. I went to school 26 years. 26 years. This book right here, I don't know nothing else. God graced me to know this book. Amen. A sinner like me. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Went from there. Amen. The dope house to God's house. God's house is much better.
Amen.
Amen. It's a good thing. This word right here. Amen. This word right here. To go from being a sinner to a saint. Some people are still sinners. Are you hearing me? Still sinners. Never got converted. Not aware of conversion. Not aware of not aware of the seasons of the Lord's work. When you're born again, you start learning the seasons of the Lord's work. In other words, you can't go and do anything. I'm not even free to go do what I want to do tonight. I just go do whatever I want to do. I'm not free. You can have at it. I can. Huh? I kind of, you know, not being a betting man, I bet you can't go do whatever you want to do tonight. I almost guarantee you can. When this seed is in you, the seed of what? The seed of God's word. Paul knew this. Peter knew this. When the seed of God's word is in you, y'all want to go over there and see it about sinners? All right. Go with me to 1 John 3. Okay, don't tell me you just studied this this afternoon. I just studied it this afternoon. Glory to God. Praise His name. Okay, you got it? Let's start at verse 1. Behold, what manner of love the Father has bestowed upon us that we should be called what?
The sons of God.
Now, when you read this in the Greek, here's how I read. What kind of foreign love is this that God then gave to us that we should be called the sons of God?
The Amplifiers calls it children of God.
Children of God, okay. So that means sons mean children, okay? Now, something, you know, I really want to go into a whole bunch of this, but it's something that y'all know Kelly Ripa got put on a Hollywood Walk of Fame, right? Yesterday, or this weekend. Well, no big deal. But it's something that she said that I think, amen, was good in her speech. She said there's probably a lot of people more deserving of this, but there would be none who is as appreciative of it. There may be some people, Lord, who are a little bit more worthy than I of salvation, but I don't want to let any be more appreciative than I am that you saved me. Amen. You know, Brother Dixon, you know about it, the faith accidents that the people used to have on the altar, because they just get them up there and start saying, thank you. Yeah. Thank you. Thank you. Somehow, when you start doing that, There is an appreciation that rises up in you. The Spirit of God starts to bang. You could see it. You could see it sometime when it came, and you could see that person's countenance change. Lips get ready to start moving because they're appreciative of it. Amen. Are you everybody here appreciative that we are called the sons of God? What Amen. Kind of foreign love is this that we should be called the sons of God? Now watch this. Therefore the world knoweth us not. They think we're strange. You know why? We don't do things the way they do them. People have a little bit of the world in them. Not all the world, the whole world. Everything about you is world, and you a church person, or you a Christian or a saint. God has bestowed this love upon us. Now watch this. Because it knew him not. Amen. Beloved, now are we the sons of God. When?
Now.
And it does not yet appear what we shall be, but we know that when he shall appear, we shall be like him, for we shall do what?
See him as he is.
Okay, now watch this. Every man, every child, right, of God, that has this hope does what?
Purifies
himself.
Even as who?
He is
pure.
So everybody has this hope. Does what? Purify himself. Listen, if we're not all the way pure today, that ought to be the avenue that we're going to. Amen. Not just any kind of way. Amen. Just live any type of way. We were sinners. Amen. We're not sinners today. We were sinners. We were the people who missed the mark. There is something called exactness. There's something called precision. There's something called fitting together. Let me tell you something. In Solomon's temple, nothing could be hammered or chiseled. If you have to hammer it and chisel it, it means it don't fit. It just don't belong. You have to be mad. You just don't belong. That right there just doesn't belong. How many would go and pray and say, God, fix me? Fix you outside and then you come in. Here we go. Whosoever committed sin transgresseth what?
Also the law.
But sin is the what?
Transgression of the law.
Oh. Now, if sin is a transgression of the law, and I'm not under the law, I'm under grace, how can I be transgressing something that I'm not under? He's going to show us this. Watch. And you know that he was manifested to take away our sins, and in him is no sin. Now, where are we?
In him.
Whosoever abided in him does what?
Sinneth not.
And whosoever sinneth had not seen him, neither known him. That's not his nature. Okay, here we go. Little children, let nobody trick you. He that does righteousness is righteous, even as he is righteous. In other words, we're not doing good stuff to become righteous. The righteousness that we've received is causing us to do good stuff. It's righteousness that's working. Not us working to become good enough before God. God made us good enough and said, now go walk in your good enough. That make sense to us? Watch. He that committed sin is what?
The devil.
But the devil did what? He sinned it from the beginning. For this purpose, the Son of God was manifested that he might destroy the works of the devil. Whoever is born of God, what?
Does not commit sin.
And some people don't care. They just sin wide open. And then in the next mouth, talk to you about God. Well, God, you wouldn't know God if he walked up. Some people wouldn't know God if he walked up in a red suit. But God, you wouldn't know nothing about God, the kingdom. Amen. How it works. Because whatever it is that's trying to bind you, I could tell you this. If you want to see God go to war, let some bind one of his saints. He'll come and break it wide open. He'll come and break one thing that's tough is coming up against the anointing. Because when you come up against the Spirit of God, let me tell you something. You could go out, you could take off with a full head of steam and run into that wall out there. You could kick and do it. And Amar gets set, go and run into that wall. Just full speed. I can guarantee you will fall before the wall. You will. You can't kick against the prayer. Amen. You keep coming up against the anointing. Keep coming up against the anointing. Keep coming up against the anointing. Praying a little prayer. Amen. Hallelujah. But you pray one too many of them. And then you cross the line. What line? I don't even... Like they told the lady, they said, you should get saved. It's Wednesday night. Get saved. The party Friday. And I love to dance. So I wait till after this party is over because I love to dance. And I want to go to that dance. Well, they looked up Friday and the lady hadn't gone to the dance. They told her, get saved and you can go on to the dance. Just get saved and go to the dance. So she got saved. And she came back that Friday and they said, I thought you loved to dance. I thought you want to go. She said the strangest thing happened. When I went to the altar, all I want to was gone. Crossing that line to the place where all of the want to is gone. Amen. Hallelujah. Glory to God. I'm back. Amen. You get close enough to me, I'll cast any devil that's in you. I'll drive him right out, make you spit him up right there on the thing. Because people are moving in demonic forces and don't know. That's okay. That's what prayer is for. To break the power of the devil. God does not like anything to have his people bound. Now Samson went to a place where he was not supposed to go. He married a woman he wasn't supposed to marry. His parents got on his case about marrying Delilah. But the Bible says they didn't know that God, amen, was using this as an occasion against the Philistines. In other words, he let this man marry outside his nation, go live down there with the enemy, let the enemy cut his hair off, gouge his eyes out, put him out there in a circle where everybody could come together in the stadium and see him who was the champion of Israel, who had tied 300 foxtails together and burned up, set them on fire, burned up all the Philistines' crops. This man was so cold, he put the gates of a city on his back and ran up the hill a mile and a quarter. He killed 1,000 men with the jawbone of an ass. But now his eyes is gone. Now his head is gone. But that little boy who took him to them two strong pillars, amen, represents the Holy Ghost. He said, one more time, Lord, just give it to me one more time. And that little boy came. He said, what are you trying to do? He said, lead me to the two strongest pillars. When he got to them pillars, bam, he hit them pillars, and it came down on all of the Philistines. And the Bible says Samson killed more in his death than he did in his life. Because God will make it work together. His people, amen, were under, amen, bondage, amen, to the Philistine. They were afraid of the Philistine. Samson would go and fight. It was the day of the judges. And then, bang, he goes and he pushes them two pillars down, amen, and all of the Philistines are brought to nothing. Amen? So, this purpose, the Son of God was manifest, that he might destroy the works of the devil. Whoever is born of God does not commit sin. Because his seed does what?
Remain in kingdom.
What is the seed?
The word.
Huh?
The word.
You mean the seed is the word? So the level of the word you got in you is the level of the seed you got in you. So if you don't have the level of the word in you, then you're going to miss, amen, this thing. You have nothing to bring forth with it. You know, when the devil, when the season comes in your life, when the enemy comes, and you have nothing to answer him with, oh, I seen it. Amen. I seen it. I seen people think they could come in the house of God, live any kind of way they want to, do whatever they want to, no discretion, no nothing. And that stinking pride. I can do this. I told the guy, can you do that, man? I can understand people do stuff that's wrong, but certain things you just don't do. Are you hearing me? Because the seed, get the seed. Amen. Bring the seed. Put the seed in you. It don't have to be about everything. It just got to be about where you are today. Where am I today? Where am I right now in my life? Let me put some seed into my life, amen, to destroy the works of the devil. Hallelujah. I know exactly where I am in my life. Is there anything need to be fixed in your life, Pastor? Yep. Fix it, Jesus. Fix it. Are y'all hearing me? Fix it, Jesus. Fix it. Amen. Isn't that wonderful?
Oh, yeah.
His seed remained in him, and he cannot sin because he is born of God. Now, when you see sin without the S, what does it mean? Nature. With the S, it means what?
Action.
Motion. Amen. Motion. Amen. So this is talking about that nature. Having that nature. Walking in that nature. Amen. Hallelujah. In this, the children of God are manifest, and the children of the devil. Whosoever does not righteousness is not of God. Neither he that loveth not his brother. Now you're going to start talking about love. You can be holy without loving your brother. It don't work. You got to go to whatever cost it is to move over into the place of love. He that hates his brother is a murderer. We know that no murder has eternal life in him. There are people, amen, who come here and they hate my guts. The hatred in them is immense. I'm talking about real bad. Hate. Amen. Hate. But you know, hell is when somebody hates you and you hate them back. It's the absence of love. Dead. Amen. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Love one another. Oh, a few moments. Love, right? Love is love. For this is the message that you have heard from the beginning, that we should love one another. Not as Cain, who was that wicked one, and slew his brother. And wherefore slew he him? Because his own works were evil, and his brother's was righteous. See why he did it? Amen. Hallelujah. He was righteous. Marvel not, my brother, if the world hates you. For we know that we have passed from death unto life, because we love the brethren. He that loveth not his brother abideth in death. Amen. Deacons, deaconess, that's one of the questions that you get in ordination. How do you know? How do you know that you can enter into the office of a deacon? Not because you're smart, not because you think da-da-da-da-da-da, whatever. I can do it because I love the brother. That's one of the questions. Amen. Might want to write it down. Amen. Because I love the brethren. Amen. And we know that we have passed from death to life because we love the brethren. He that loveth not, okay. Whosoever hated his brother is a murderer. And you know that no murderer hath eternal life abiding in him. Hereby perceive we the love of God, because he laid down his life for us, and we ought to lay down our lives for the brethren. But whoso hath this world's good, seeth his brother have need, and shutteth up his bowels of compassion, from him dwelleth the love of God in him. My little children, let us not love in word, neither in tongue, but in deed and in truth. And hereby we know that we are of the truth, and shall assure our heart before him. Watch this. For if our heart condemn us, God is greater than our heart, and knoweth all things. Beloved, if our heart condemn us not, then have we confidence toward God. And whatsoever we ask, we receive of him, because we keep his commandments, and do those things that are pleasing in his sight. And this is the commandment. To admit you're going to like this one. This is his commandment. Watch this. That we should believe on the on the what? We should believe on that name and do what?
Love one another.
And love one another as he gave commandment. Now there's two commandments right there. And that's what they're called. They're called commandments. We're commanded to believe on the name of Jesus. We are commanded to love one another. So we believe on the name, love one another. Believe on the name, love one another. I want to tell you, saints, something. Amen. I want to tell you, saints, something. When people call back and say what hospitality they received when they came to the blessing of Abraham on Sunday, man, I tell you what, that put a big smile on them. People are just so warm, Pastor. They just greeted us. Amen. The one lady over here, amen, she gave a praise, amen, to Sister Stephanie. I don't know. Amen. She said she thought I was the earth. Amen. Which is a good sign, though.
Amen.
Huh? That's a good sign. Because in the kingdom of God, the urchins, are great. Oh no, it's not the one who sits in his big old chair and everybody kind of wipe sweat off his head and three or four little guys running around behind him with a briefcase. Jesus might say to a lot of them, you have your reward already. But the greatest among you shall be the servant of all. Servant. So many people come in the house of God, they don't have no servant spirit. Come here to serve. Amen. Anybody who comes to the blessing of Abraham, you're here to help me. Amen. You're not here to rule me. I'm not going to allow you to. That's a devil. That's what he wanted to do. He wanted to ascend up to God. And I'm not saying I'm God. I'm not. I'm just on assignment by God. And I love it. I'm having fun. Doors are open. Amen. We're going to, you know, years ago, this guy from Pomona, who used to come to Chicago and minister. I'm going to Pomona. I'm going to Pomona. I'm going to hit right off of there. And I think you go left. If you go left, you're going to Chino. But if you go right, right down that road, it take you right into Pomona. They got palm trees all over the place in Pomona. I'm going to preach in Pomona. Amen. Going to preach. Doors are open. Ways are being made. Hallelujah. Glory to God. I'm just waiting now. Amen. Hallelujah. Glory to God. God, the money people are going to show up over here. The ones going to come crying out, what must I do to be saved? And we're going to do the commandment. We're going to tell them to believe on the name of the Lord Jesus. Hallelujah. You shall be saved. We're going to tell them, Lord, love one another. Let love go in your heart. Right? How does love get in the heart? And I'm close. Anybody know how love, the love of God, gets in the heart?
The shed brought in our heart by the Holy Ghost.
Oh, boy, we got some Bible scholars up in here. Amen. All you have to do is say it, and they know it. The love of God has been shared abroad in our hearts by the Holy Ghost. The Holy Ghost will get us to walk in love and believe on the name of Jesus. When you see the day of Pentecost taking place, first thing they did, name of Jesus, right? Amen. The name of Jesus. And they love one another. Amen. Glory to God. Amen. Wonderful. That's the new birth. That's being born of the Spirit of God. That's walking in the light of what God has done for us. Amen. And not go around making up stuff. You cannot go around just making up stuff. I wish Jeffrey was here, because he would tell me that. In the danger, you can't go around making up stuff. Amen. Hallelujah. Thank God for our wonderful president, who I heard say that over and over and over again. Wow. He said, you can't go around making up stuff. Amen. Glory to God. We got this book right here. We got the book right here. We got the book right here. We got it. Amen. Father, in Jesus' name, we love you, praise you. Thank you, Father God, for what you've done, what you're doing, what you're going to do, Father God. We have confidence in everything you've begun, a good work in us, and you're performing unto the day of the Lord Jesus. Father, I want to thank you, hallelujah, for this month of October, Father God. I want to thank you, Father God, for those who are standing in the circle of prayer, Father God, crying out for souls to be saved, Father. Hallelujah, souls to be saved. As Paul said, Father God, you sent your son into the world to save sinners. He was a chief sinner. You saved him, Father. So we know, hallelujah, you can save, hallelujah, anybody. We asking you, Father God, hallelujah, to bring those across our path. Hallelujah. Let us be armed with the preparation of the gospel of peace. Let us feet be shod. Let evangelism, let a fire of evangelism breakout in this place in the name of Jesus. I pray like that, Father, because I know it's your will. Hallelujah. It's your will for the fires of evangelism to break forth, hallelujah, in this place, Father. I thank you that it's full. I thank you it's full, Father God, of truly converted laborers. Hallelujah, Father God. Truly converted laborers. Send conversion, Father God. Break the power of the flesh. Let no flesh glory in your sight. But let flesh be crucified, Father. Let no flesh be seen. But cover us with your glory, Father.
Yes.
Cover us with your gold. Cover us with your glory. Let us lay, Father God, on the sacrifice that you gave us through our Lord Jesus Christ. Let us be fitly joined together. Hallelujah, covered in your glory. In the name of Jesus, Father. And we'll give you all the praise. We'll give you all the glory. We'll make known your deeds among the people. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. God bless you. I'll see y'all on Sunday. Tune in. 641-715-3580. Access code 610-739-POUND. Amen.